Be the Good is all about people doing good in the world while following their passions. Good for their own souls and for others. I'm Kate Cherichello, and welcome to today's episode. If you are enjoying these stories, please subscribe and leave a review on Apple Podcasts. It would mean so much. You can also join our Facebook community under the group title, Be the Good with Kate Cherichello. Let's spread a little more goodness in the world.
Welcome to Be the Good. The founder of Raising Men and Women Lawn Care Service, Rodney Smith Jr., started mowing lawns in Alabama as a way to give back. He now runs a nationwide nonprofit empowering youth to make a difference in their communities. I do not know how he found the time to chat with me today, but I am certainly grateful he did. So Rodney, thank you so much for being here.
Yes, thank you for having me on. I really appreciate it.
Oh, you bet. My pleasure, for sure. I told Rodney, you know, a friend of mine sent me his Instagram and said, you probably have already been following Rodney, but if not, he would make such a great guest. And I had not. And then I started to just get lost in all of the stories and all of the posts. And it's amazing all that he's done. So Rodney, just tell us a little bit about who you are and what you do in your own words.
Yeah, so my name is Rodney Smith Jr., and I'm the founder of an organization called Raising Men and Women's Lawn Care Service, and we mow free lawns for the elderly, disabled, single parents, and veterans. And we have about 3,000 kids nationwide taking part in something we call the 50-yard challenge, and that's just them mowing free lawns in their community for the elderly, disabled, single parents, and veterans. And once they complete that, I personally deliver them a brand new mower, weed eater, and blower for completing this challenge. So that's a little bit more myself. And yeah, I just love what I do. Every morning I wake up and I get a chance to make a difference in my community.
Oh, that's fantastic. And did you say you hand them a new mower at the end of the challenge?
Yeah, so a new mower, weed eater, and blower for completing it. And that's it's incredible. Not just mowing lawns. We also include raking leaves and snow shoveling. So it's a year-round activity.
Oh, amazing. Rodney, how did you end up doing this nonprofit and doing the work you do? What was your path?
Yeah, so back in 2015, I came across an elderly man outside mowing his lawn, and it looked like he was struggling, so I pulled over and helped him out. And that night, I decided I'll start mowing free lawn for the elderly, disabled, single parents, and veterans right here in Huntsville, Alabama. At first, my goal was to mow 40 lawns by the end of winter because, you know, at the time, I was a senior in college, and I thought I could mow 40 lawns, but I mowed 40 lawns so quick that my goal was 100. A month and a half later, I reached my 100th lawn. And that's when the idea of Raising Men and now Raising Women's Lawn Care Service came about. And here we are today.
Wow. How much growth in such a short amount of time, too.
Yes.
Now, throughout the pandemic, granted, mm-hmm. you had more of an outdoor business, but what changes have you had to make, pivots and whatnot? And obviously the pandemic's still going on. I know you work with a lot of people who are by themselves as well in terms of the elderly and whatnot. So how has the past 2 years, how have they shifted what you do and any of your programs and connections?
Yeah. So, you know, when the pandemic first started, you know, it didn't really affect us much because, you know, the elderly people, they're going to stay inside and we just come by and mow. So it didn't really have a negative effect. It really kind of had a positive effect in a way because we had hundreds of kids sign up for our 50-yard challenge because they were home and they had nothing else to do. So that was, you know, you could say a blessing in disguise because yes. We had so many kids signing up and so many kids getting out there and making a difference in their community. And if it wasn't for the pandemic, they probably wouldn't have known about the organization because, you know, people were home. So people were sharing things that kids can do, and someone came across our organization and, you know, people just sharing it. So, you know, it's kind of been in a way a good thing, but, you know, it's still a pandemic. It's still dangerous. So, you know, but everyone kept safe. That's the most important thing.
And how wonderful too, to get, you gave the opportunity for kids to get out of their house. I mean, yeah. That was so needed, right? Getting out, yeah. Breathing that fresh air, doing something good. So that's fantastic. Not one of our normal five, but I saw you've been on like every major news publication. Your Instagram is blowing up. How did you go from, you know, being a small nonprofit that was just mm-hmm. starting out to this? I'm so intrigued by that.
Oh, just, you know, just stepping out the box. People ask, say all the time, oh, I want to do something with what you're doing. And it's just about just doing it. And what I think what really put us on the national stage is back in 2017, at the time I was getting my master's in social work, and I was in my internship one day on my lunch break, and I was watching this video on Netflix of this guy that traveled the world off the acts of kindness to others. And that gave me the idea of something called 50 States, 50 Lawns. And that's when I decided I'll drive to all 50 states and make people aware of the organization and, you know, encourage kids to sign up for a 50-yard challenge. So I went to all 50 states, moved for the elderly, disabled, single parents and veterans, at least one person in each state. And I've done that since 12 times. 10 have been for mowing for different causes. And 2 have been like different Christmas tours, which I just finished. Like the previous Christmas tour we just finished was giving out gifts to kids with cancer and stuff like that. So when I was going to all 50 states at the start, and this is how the national news came about, and just the word got around, and that's how kids in different states found out about the organization. So that was just stepping out the box and encouraging kids to take part in our 50-yard challenge. And I do a few 50 state tours a year, mowing tours, and even Christmas ones at the end of the year. But that they really help get the word out about the organization and make it become the national stage.
What an incredible example too of how anyone can make such a huge difference if they have an idea, have a passion, and then put their mind to it. And like you said, I love that stepping out of the box. You kept doing that and you keep doing that.
Yeah, man, it's important just to step out and do something different.
Great. Rodney, what are some examples, I always ask, of examples of goodness and those good news moments, you know, from people you've helped, from kids that you've worked with? I would love to hear some stories.
Yeah, so the good news, I mean, it's always good news, especially the ones for you with veterans, you know, when you get the chance to mow for a veteran. I've done 50 state tours for veterans before, going to all 50 states, thanking veterans for the service and mowing the lawns. But you know, some stories I met, there's one veteran out in Illinois. He's a World War II veteran. He's still running marathons. He's about 90-something years old. And, you know, just getting a chance to move for him. And then him showing me pictures of him when he was in World War II. And he's remembering everything just like it was yesterday. And, you know, just so many stories like that from great veterans that are out there. You know, just something about that, you know, just veterans, and they serve this country. So in a way that we can give back to them, and my way of giving back is through free lawn care. So it's always an honor to mow for a veteran and hear the stories firsthand, and them remembering every single thing like it was yesterday. Yeah. I feel like a kid being told a story during story time and whenever they talk. So it's pretty cool.
Oh, fantastic. And I bet that's really amazing too, with the different generations, with some of the kids who are mowing lawns, right? Getting to interact with all these people.
Yeah, and, you know, there's even a kid out in Michigan. His mom was telling me that he grew to love a lot of veterans that he mowed for, and some of them sadly passed away, and it, you know, had an impact on his life. So, you know, but, you know, he got a chance to meet them and got a chance to hear their stories. And I think that's what's important. And he's going to remember those moments forever.
That's so true. It's come up so much in this show too. And I'm sure with what you're doing is that one interaction or that 1 hour you spend with someone, how much of a difference that it can make, you know, years and years down the line, right?
Yeah.
Rodney, what are some sayings that you find yourself repeating over and over again with the people that you work with?
Well, one, it's kind of a simple quote and kind of an obvious quote, but, you know, Gary V. Are you familiar with Gary V?
I don't think so. Gary V?
Yeah, he's a popular guy on Instagram and Twitter and stuff. But he said he gives advice and stuff. And one thing he always said was, one day you're going to die. Like, simple as that. He was talking to someone, what's the best advice you can get to me? One day you're going to die. And the idea behind that is what I got is, you know, why wait around? Why not do it now? Do it now. You have an idea, do it now. Don't wait. Because eventually, one day, sadly, we're all going to pass on. But, you know, you're here now. So let's get it done. Let's do what we can. And let's make the best of this moment, you know. So that's probably my most favorite quote right now. One day, you will die. And every day, I can be like laying in bed sometimes. And sometimes I just think about life and think about everything coming to end one day. And just a black screen. I just get up, man. One day it's all going to be, I'm not going to be able to do this. So right now I'm going to take advantage of it and do what I can. So that's my favorite quote right now.
That's so on point. It's so needed, right? We all could use that reminder, especially on days when we're not as motivated, right? Or feeling just so pulled down from everything around us, right? Of we have the power to do something.
Exactly. And it's just do it. Don't sit on that idea, because that idea can be groundbreaking. It can change someone's life, not just your life, someone else's might be the impact from that idea. So just do it.
And look, you've impacted thousands. Do you even have a number at this point? Just thousands upon thousands?
Yeah, right now it's about 3,000 kids taking part in the organization. So, you know, slowly growing.
That's incredible. So just right now, 3,000. My goodness. Yeah. Hey, Rodney, where can we find you, follow you, all of that? Give us all the links and I'll have them in the show notes as well.
Yeah, so I'm on Twitter. It's I am Rodney Smith. On Facebook and Instagram, it's Rodney Smith Jr. And our website is weareraisingmen.com, weareraisingwomen.com, or raisingmenandwomenslawncareservice.com.
Excellent. Hey, Rodney, are there any events coming up?
Yeah, so I'm planning on giving at least one lawnmower away in each state to a kid that doesn't have a lawnmower but would like to take on our 50-yard challenge. So I'm planning to go around all 50 states again, probably in January, since the season's much slower. And I'll give a kid a chance, a lawnmower, so they can take part this spring, summer, and fall.
Rodney, you're a remarkable human being.
Thank you
so much for finding the time. I know you've already done at least two lawns this morning, haven't you?
Yeah.
So thank you so much. I'll let you get on with your day. You're doing such great work. I can't thank you enough.
Oh, I appreciate you having me on. I really appreciate it.
Thanks so much for listening to Be the Good with Kate Cherichello. Whether you're listening on YouTube or via podcast, it would mean the world if you liked, subscribed, and or left a review. You heard about the good? Now go out and be the good in your life this week. If you have stories of good news that need to be shared, please send me a message. Thanks again, and have a great week.